Here we have the Fujitsu Mini Split Air Conditioner Indoor PCB of a 2.5 ton unit. Today, we will repair it, and I will guide you step by step on where to start testing and what needs to be repaired afterward. First, the method I always recommend is a physical inspection, which gives me a good idea of what might be wrong with the PCB just by looking at it. If we take a closer look at this PCB, I can see that the fuse has blown. Additionally, the communication IC seems to have some visible damage, but we'll need to test it further to determine the exact cause, because right now it's only showing signs of scorching. I don't know the full reason yet, but we'll have to check it. Moreover, there's a ZNR here, and the fact that it's burnt indicates that there were extremely high voltages present, likely above 250 volts. This is why the PCB stopped working and developed an issue. So, let's start testing, and I'll provide you with all the necessary information step by step. So before we begin testing, we'll first remove the fuse and the Zener diode from the board. Then, we will check the rest of the components. First, I'll desolder these parts and take them out. I have my desoldering tools ready, and I'll add a bit of fresh solder to the joints. Adding new solder to the connection can make a significant difference. After this, I'll use my desoldering station, which I built myself. You can see I've placed it on the board, and it has automatically sucked the solder, disconnecting the wire completely. Now both components have been removed, so we'll clean the points. The method for cleaning is that if the holes haven't fully cleared out, you can add more solder, which heats up the connection and helps remove it smoothly. Now both points are cleared, now you can see the holes with the zoomed in view. As you can see, the fuse is out, and I've got it in my hand. Next, I will check if anything else is damaged. First, let's take a look here. You can see the line filter, and next to it is the bridge rectifier. We'll test these components first up to the capacitors, and then I'll check the switching IC. So let's start testing these components step by step. So first, let's take the multimeter. When you need to check the line filter, set the multimeter to kilo ohms. My meter is automatic, so it detects whether it's ohms or kilo ohms on its own. But if you have a manual meter, you can set it yourself. Now when I check the line filter, it shows 1.6 ohms, which is fine, and the other side also shows 1.6 ohms, so it's perfectly fine. Next, there's an inductor here, and when I check it, it shows 4.2 ohms, which is also good. Now, let's move on to checking the bridge rectifier. To test it, we'll set the multimeter to diode mode. Now, I've placed the probes on one side, and it's showing a voltage drop on all points, which means all the diodes are in good condition. After that, when I reverse the polarity of the probes, there should be no reading at all. As you can see, there was a brief reading, but it quickly disappeared. This is common inside a PCB when you check. Sometimes it shows a slight voltage, but then it drops. There shouldn't be any voltage showing at any point, which means the bridge rectifier is perfectly fine. Next, let's move on to the capacitor. Visually, the capacitor looks fine. There's no sign of any defect, but I'll still test it just to be sure. Now, first, I'll replace the Zener diode. I have another Zener diode here, so I'll place it in position and solder it in place, ensuring it fits well and doesn't come out. Before soldering, I'll apply some solder paste because it's essential for making the soldering process perfect. That's done. Now, I'll install the fuse. I've checked many components, and visually, I don't see any problems. I've also confirmed everything with the multimeter. Next, there are some diodes here that I'll check as well. I'll set the multimeter to diode mode and check them. As you can see, they look perfectly fine. Now, I'll check them in reverse polarity, and again, they look good. After this, we have the capacitor, which seems a bit short-circuited. Let's check it out. To test the capacitor, there are a couple of methods. One is using the multimeter, and the other is to remove it from the circuit board for testing. Additionally, my method involves setting the multimeter to continuity mode. Since capacitors block DC voltages and allow AC voltages to pass, when I test it, it should either not beep or beep briefly before stopping. Now let's check it. As you can see, it beeped and then stopped, which indicates that the capacitor is in good condition. Now, I'll test the chopper. For this, I'll set the multimeter to ohms or kilo ohms. As you can see, there are two points here, one winding and another point for the second winding. When I test both of them, it shows a reading of 1.6 ohms, which is perfectly fine. The second winding also shows the same good reading. Next, we'll check the switching IC, and after that, we'll power it up. To check the switching IC, I'll place one probe on pin number 1 and test from there to the end. There shouldn't be any reading at all. As I'm checking all the points now, I'm not getting any readings. There are two pins on the back, and as I check those, you can see there are no readings. Now I'll switch the positive probe and bring the negative probe to this side. When I test it again, you can see a reading shows up, but then it drops again. We can check the next point, and if we don't get a reading, that's okay too. Now, as we check the next point, we see there are some voltages coming through. This means that the switching IC appears to be functioning well. However, the final test will be when we power it up. That's when we'll know if it's working properly or not. Now, I'm going to power it up since everything looks good so far. I'll connect it directly to the electricity and check if it works or not. However, when I powered it on, the display didn't turn on, so I need to investigate further to identify the issue. First, I'll check the power supply because I haven't checked the connector yet. Let's set the multimeter to AC volts. We need to check the AC voltage on both the white and black connectors. As I'm checking, there are no voltages coming through, which means the connector's fuse has likely blown. The connector does have a fuse, so let's check that. If the fuse isn't working, we can apply power directly to see if the unit functions. I've disconnected the connector and bypassed it. Now, as you can see, electricity should flow through, and I've installed a loop for this purpose. Now I'm going to test it directly and show you whether it works or not. The display has been powered on, but it's showing an error because no communication is happening in the absence of outdoor board, and a thermistor is also missing. So we're likely to get a communication error along with a sensor error. In conclusion, our PCB is now fixed after changing two fuses and a Zener diode. We've successfully repaired it. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.